For day four of Vlogmas 2024, we find ourselves up in North Austin at Benbrook Park. This course was newly redesigned about a year and a half ago, and there's been so much love and work put in by the community, especially the Hill Country Heisers Disc Golf Club. They got all this amazing signage up now throughout the course that I don't think was there last time we played this one. Obviously the legendary, infamous triple mando on hole one here is a nice little touch, make you remember the course, and they added the sign, which is taking away a little bit of that height that I like to use. But anyways, if you're here at Benbrook, check it out, scan the codes, maybe join the Hill Country Heisers so you can give back to your community, help beautify your local course, because I heard this course used to be quite a bear, like really rough on the edges and like not that much fun to play. And now I'd argue it's one of the most fun courses to play in North Austin. So really excited to show you guys this if you didn't already see it from last year's Vlogmas. And we did find this cloud breaker on the course yesterday, so we upgraded the bag. Now we have 5 discs in there. And because of that, you know, we got some extra inventory slots being a new level 10 disc golfer. So I added chalk. I'm not going to have to use the dirt anymore. I'm pretty happy about that. And we're on hole one, par four, 481 feet. They keep moving this out of bounds line into the left more and more every time I come here, which I don't hate because it creates even more risk for the player who's trying to get the long two look on this one, because it is very two-able. If you hit that turnover driver, get it to come back, which I'm going to go for here off the tee. There's also a straight shot through this low ceiling that sets you up for another straight shot, and a bit of a mounded green here is the last thing to worry about. But I like hole one as a starter. Trying to skirt underneath the sign, get a little cheeky, go for the two here. It feels like a mandatory for me at Benbrook. Now we just need that thing to fade, but it is very straight. I gave it some height though, come on. Oh no. I hit the last tree that you gotta beat. And that's gonna be tough. We're gonna be out of bounds early up here. Let's see if we can save par. We gotta try to pitch for bogey here. Keep it safe, play the faith. Maybe we'll chip it in, take our four that way. In tournament, I'd like to play putter, or even forehand off the tee here. But I like having fun when we're filming here for Vlogmas, so I gotta go for the two when available. And this one's very gettable. Little baby turnover to the bottom of the hill. Take our medicine here and move on, because there's a lot of birdie opportunities at Benbrook. Can't tell you guys how excited I am for a chalk bag in the kit today. Big time. Yeah, and I really like hole one here. Like I said, not too hard to get the birdie if you're just playing it safe, but it takes two technical shots, risk reward. You can get a two on it, and it's got a little bit of a sketchy green to keep you honest. We'll take bogey here to start. This is some of the most realistic tee signage I've seen in terms of the actual tree placement, the lines available, and you gotta love it. We get a lot of signs that, you know, they, like yesterday's signs, you know, they got a lot of extra on there. Not really a lot to help me play the course. 282 feet, one tree to beat here. Out of bounds on your right, thick bush line, and water on your left. Basket's on a cute little tower over there. This brand new faith, well, a couple rounds in, you know, still flying pretty brand new. Should be our ticket to Ace Town. If that can stay up in the air, go. Oh, those guys started cheering at the same time my disc was close. So I was like, oh, yeah, it was close. It was a good birdie. If you're just tuning in for day four of Vlogmas because you love Benbrook, or because you just figured out about the channel, these faiths right here in pink and in red have been unboxed and added to the inventory list. So hit me up on Instagram, Facebook Messenger, or via the email in the description, and we can get you guys some of these faiths to try out. I think they're fantastic approach discs. A little deep for my liking, putting-wise. I'm making it happen right here because I'm still level 10, trying to level up my disc golf game. But, yeah, I think they have a use in your game regardless of if you like the depth of putting or not. At only 246 feet, hole three is going to be one of the shortest holes on the property. However, I think it's one of the more beautiful holes out here as well. You could blindfold someone, throw them on this tee box, and probably convince them they're in a number of states on the east coast of the U.S. You know, you could tell me I'm in upstate New York or something like that here on this nice canopy tunnel shot we have. The main obstacle is gonna be this gnarled branch, keeping you in check if you're trying to ace run this thing. Play the slide play if you're trying to play it smart and get the birdie, or flirt with that branch if you like being the hero. I'm gonna try to split the difference on those. And who knows, maybe we'll get a happy accident ace, but ideally, I'm just gonna slide this one up, take my birdie, and move on. Since I started bogey, I got work to do. Fresh faith here. Ooh, flirted with the branch. And there's the perfect example of how those fades fly. If you didn't already email me after three holes of this one, what are you doing? Are you blind? Are you blind? Well, we got our first headbanger of Vlogmas here. We like our birdies served close. When you get the Connor Riley Tour Series faith that we just unearthed from the history books, you too can score birdies on 250-foot holes. Hole 4 out here at Benbrook is so much so the signature hole of this course, at least in my opinion and that of many others, that they created their own mascot for the course, the Benbrook Behemoth, the plastic monster that lives in this little pond between you and the basket after you throw a nice tunnel shot off the tee, land it short of that pond. You're going to have a touchy approach, pond short, little creek behind not too far as well. Really love this hole. One of the best holes on the property. Property line on the right is going to be out of bounds. Thick woods on the left to avoid. And you have this tunnel created by the stand of trees on the right and these overhanging branches on the left at the midpoint of the fairway here. I like going mid-range off the tee. Set me up for a short approach in the range of 200 feet if I execute. And as you get up there, there's just these three cypress, these three willow trees up there in the middle, three or four of them, that really kind of make you pick your shot coming into the green and don't just give you pure freedom. Really love this hole. This Delaware compass that you yourself can get only at otbdisc.com is gonna be the perfect disc for this shot. Let me show you. Little hyzer on the release, nice stand up there, and that is center cut. Perfect window to the basket there. Now, I haven't added my Bushnell rangefinder to the bag yet. I haven't unlocked it, but one day I will. I'm gonna say this shot's about 200 feet away, maybe just above it. I do have to say a big thanks to my guy Carl down in Florida who hooked me up with his very own Bushnell rangefinder since I lost mine at USDGC practice. So Carl, you're the real MVP, my friend. I got laser eyes though, so about 200 foot, medium faith here. A little bit left. I'm gonna need that to carry the water. Oh my God, the behemoth. It ate my faith, you guys. OTB, I'm gonna need, oh wait, you can't go to the OTB, only myself. I'm gonna have to go to the box, you know, go to the box. Oh my God, I like that one. I don't want that to be gone. Who has a disc retriever?
Need to unlock that
too. I gotta be level 25 before I get a disc retriever. Yeah, I'm gonna say we crossed right about on this path right here. Pretty tragedy, pretty bad. Pretty tragic. Try to get cute though and save a stroke here. The behemoth, you know, it got us. You know, I shouldn't have told the legend of it. I awoke it from its depths and it came to snatch my disc. It wasn't my fault. It was the monster. If you play Benbrook and you rescue that thing from the behemoth for me, I will give you a disc for payment and be so happy. Because I like that thing. It's very pretty. It has sentimental value. RIP to the beautiful blue faith. And also RIP to my scorecard, because I'm even with two birdies through four holes at Benbrook, and I'd love to be four through four. But it's okay, you know. Hole 5, par 4, another opportunity to score. This one zigzags left, then back right, out of bounds, surrounding that left side, natural out of bounds on the right side, keeping you in check and in the fairway. I was just looking back out of the tee as we wait on this group ahead, and You know, I got some flashbacks to filming in Wimberley yesterday. I feel like, you know, if we're in Wimberley, shave this thing up a little bit, boom, bam. You got your eye slit hole. We love it. About 135 feet. We just need a tree to hit your arm on somewhere. Time to break the clouds. Caught the last two trees on the corner to beat, but I should be at the corner, still in birdie range. You know, now would be a good time to have a forehand overstable approach style disc, but my best forehand option is this cloud breaker. So that's what I'm gonna go with. Just play it wide. Try to play the skip in. Once again, we have out of bounds long and left. Right side's just the ick. Maybe we can play the little skip in too with that guy. Go. Ooh, okay. I don't hate it. You know, having the wrong disc gives us an opportunity to accidentally shank it into the basket. We got us a putt for birdie. All right, we're in the Willow Branch prison over here. But we got a window to deliver the goods for birdie. Got it. And then we got some nice portobello mushrooms. Snack on, get us going for the next hole. Oh, that's pretty tasty, you know, I like that. At 250 feet, hole six has a unique snaking nature to the fairway. As a right-hand player, there's two options. You can play straight at it through this slightly more narrow gap that if you pure it, leads you right to the basket. You also have this left side of the initial tree trunk here in the middle. You can play on anhyzer, flatten out, try to give yourself a right side of the basket look. I prefer the left side, drag it over, have it flatten out. Try to get it right there. You could maybe do forehand if you're just trying to play for some kind of a look. And as a lefty, you play like a understable hyzer that stands up to flat. But I like the nuance to this hole for being short. It's repeatable, it's unique, and it's challenging. Brand new faith down the left side here. Have it pan out. I'm happy with anything inside of 20 feet here. That's a little bit high, but with the faith's depth, I thought I might need some extra height to give it time to come back in. Found that circle's edge putt, nice and clean over there. Here we are inside the circle, 25 footer. Man, that chalk's making a world of difference with my grip on the putting green. I cannot be happier to have the tools I need to try to score my best to entertain you guys. Hole seven here at Benbrook's, 313 feet, plays out of a narrow gap into the wide open. Usually a bit of wind on this hole, and it is an elevated basket. Out of bounds, also long, that wraps around to the left. I'm gonna go compass, because I think that's my best option out of my four here. I just gotta put up quite a bit of hyzer since we have some headwind. All right, put enough hyzer, got a little straight slide, and we got a putt. We'll take it. Chalk bag also means easy wind reads. Shout out. Oh, just a little bit too right and low. Off the cage. I do love this tower. Makes it prettier to me than just like an elevated pole on a hole. So if you have the time, you have the money, I think it's good. Adds beauty to the course, makes you remember the hole a little bit more. We got ourselves a par. Hole eight's 305 feet, and I'd argue it's one of my least favorite out here on a course that's pretty polished. This gap up the middle is just a little bit punishing and a little bit too angular, in my opinion, to reward the up the gut shots. So you're gonna be at a big advantage if you have a spike forehand on this hole, and that's what I'm gonna do with my cloud breaker. Put it up in the clouds, try to get right of the basket because there's water left and you don't want to get wet. Not in disc golf. That's so sawed off, but the good thing is You can saw it off really bad and still have a 30 footer, so we'll see where we're at. Circle two look here. Like I said, I felt like I was as right as you can possibly get, and I'm only 25, 30 feet right of the basket, a little bit short as well. Just a good reminder to miss right on here if you're going spike forehand. One day I'm gonna figure out this circle two putt with the faith, let me tell you, one day. Wow, there's some sizable bass right in here. You love to see a healthy ecosystem and disc golf coinciding with that. That's right, I'm looking at you, ball golf. Thanks, Megan. I guess tied for the shortest hole is gonna be hole 9, 248 feet, same distance as hole 3. Low ceiling here off the gap, off the tee instead of down the gap. Mandatory tree, keeping us left, making you not be able to play the spike hyzer out to the right side. I definitely prefer approach disc forehand on this shot just because of the low ceiling off the tee, but I'm gonna go with that flippy faith. Try to hit the angle right. A little too flat. It's gonna cut curl a little bit left though, and we're gonna have a circle one putt for birdie. Not too mad at it. Maybe just outside the circle here with just the slightest wind in your face. Fade! No! I said fade. Needed a little more hyzer out of the hand off the tee there. Because I got to put it in circle one so I can make putts, apparently. It is back nine snack time at Benbrook Park. Hole 10, 500, 3 feet, par four. Mandatory right here on this first tree, keeping you into the gap. Not allowing you to throw out over the walking path or to skirt this initial fairway. Bends to the right after about 300 or so feet. I'm gonna go forehand based off my disc selection that I have here. I think it's the best option to try to get down there and maybe slightly around the corner. Don't do too much. Just make sure to stretch it a little bit. Oh, that's inside. Sawed that one off, didn't get it flat enough. I'm gonna have a, most likely a prickly approach. I got pretty lucky, found a little pocket over here. A little bit of that local love, maybe. Make sure I'm not gonna hit my arm here. Put the want on it, that's for sure. And we got a putt, we got a birdie look. Look at the beautiful fall colors popping out here in Benbrook, North Austin. I don't know if y'all can identify that tree species for us that has the fall colors. It kind of almost has like a ginkgo style leaf. They're looking mighty cute, and I kind of, you know, I might want a bonsai one, so. Let us know the species, or we'll just Google lens it after this shot, after we knock in this putt for birdie, right around this dead tree. That unfortunately will probably not be with us too much longer by the looks of it. And it looks like a decent obstacle for this green, so maybe we can plant a new one. I like that idea. Hole 11 is actually gonna take the cake for the shortest hole on the course, 225, dead straight ahead. Apparently there's a big snapping turtle that lives on the left in these waters, so you probably don't wanna test him over there. There is this little scaredy cat route on the right if you wanna skip it back in, which a lot of players are gonna take. And you know, I can't be too mad at you for doing it, but throw a burner disc in your bag that fits for the shot shape and work on the shot, because I love this straight shot here. Going with that brand new faith. Ear to chains. Oh, I played it with such touch, trying to avoid the dangerous putting lanes long. Still slid long, but we have a birdie look. We'll take it. I don't know about y'all, but I think the water bottle mini marker is absolutely a play early in your disc golf career. stay hydrated, mark your lies in a semi-circular fashion, simultaneously. Score birdies too, when you get the faith. Hole 12, AKA bombs over Benbrook. It's gonna be your biggest opportunity to let it air out on this course, par four. 524 feet, dead straight ahead. Bit of a narrow hallway all throughout if you're not going over the top, but I myself love bombing either a big placement hyzer, which I think I'll do with this shot since I only have one driver right now, and I'd like to keep it, or you can kind of play a straight shot to the middle and play another slightly bending shot into the green. Cloudbreaker, medium height hyzer. Hopefully I can be on that left side of the fairway up there. Oh, that's a little too hyzered. I need to hit a treetop now. Right now, hit a tree. Yes, got a little treetop. We're sitting in that small grove of trees on the left side fairway, but there's windows over there. There's opportunities. I'm gonna have to utilize all of what my mama gave me here. Lean out to the right. Compass forehand? I think that's my best option. Look at the finesse. Big Jerm would be so proud of me right now. Thanks for paving the way, big guy. Woo! A little high, a little right. Got it to stick. Really enjoy this hole. One of my favorites out here. It's rewarding if you pure it. There's some enticing lines over the top and a lot of different ways to play it, but also a lot of different ways to play it wrong. As we step into the confinements of hole 13's tee area, I couldn't be more happy to have a wide rim driver to skip on the ground on this shot. Because really, the only way to get to this one is to play a shot that gets out there towards that strip of brown dirt in the middle and skips about 100 feet left. 281, but you're gonna wanna throw your fastest, most overstable disc and get that early ground play. Skip away. Sorry, babe, put my stuff in your way like usual. I'm really good at that, you know? All right, cloudbreaker, groundbreaker. Groundbreaking shot, nice straight skip, possibly parked. Almost hit the tree ahead, roller coaster of emotions. But I'm like the duck on top of the water. You see nothing. Thank you, thank you. So easy, just get your wide rim driver, hit the ground, skip. Since Megan loves challenging me, she has requested I throw the orange faith here. Straight at it, typically I go forehand spike hyzer. Here on hole 14, 245. Kind of a wall of trees in front of you in the basket. And it does open up just behind that wall to give you some open lanes. But I gotta go straight at it. With the beat up faith, I'm gonna put endless amounts of hyzer on this one. Endless hyzer, gets up to edge, scoots through the gap, peered the gap. Thank you, Megan, for challenging me to be a better disc golfer and helping me have an opportunity for birdie. Well, maybe Megan was right, because look at this thing. Don Texas slid right on up to close, and one, give me that. I thought I bled another stroke to the terrible towers of Benbrook, but I didn't. Got a birdie. Hole 15 at Benbrook is going to be the longest hole on the course, 641 feet. Pretty generous sized gap, nothing really in the way, except if you're just a long arm guy who can touch this thing, it might be slightly in your head. So because of that, I'm going to tee a little bit more from the middle than I'd prefer to here, since the right side does open up the gap. So if your arms aren't at risk of hitting this, I suggest teeing from right about here. Open up that gap, but I'm going to have to tee right here from the middle. Make the most of it, avoid the out of bounds to the right by maintaining my hyzer angle the whole time with this cloudbreaker. Thick tree line on the left, but you have a decent amount of room. As long as you put it close to the OB line, you shouldn't skip into the woods. Old rim cloudbreaker over the amber or golden waves of green. There we go, right in the middle. made a little over 400 feet of progress, so pretty simple approach from there, just to hyzer back in. All right, basket's just underneath this large tree that you can see in the back there. Probably got about 200 feet in, going stable faith. Yeah, that ought to be in circle one. All right, here we go, another little dapper tapper for the birdie here. No defense there when you got the jumper in your back pocket. At 320, hole 16 is gonna be a perfect ace run opportunity for this compass if I hit it right. Mandatory, forcing you down the gap. No backhand spike hyzers here. Water on the left. Well, we ain't even thinking about that because we got the truest flying mid-range in the game that we got from OTB Discs. Free shipping with code Connor. Shank it low, slide it up. Maybe I just want an opportunity to finally make a circle two putt. That's all. For a standing putt, you thinking flippy one or stable one? Stable disc, standing putt. See if we got that kind of distance in us. Oh, definitely don't have the stander, so I had to do the step through there. And the crossbar tickled us away from what honestly felt like it might have been a make. I don't hate it there. Take my easy three, move on. This one used to be on one of those towers that they moved to some of the other holes on the course. And, you know, maybe they have plans for another tower here. As the sun begins to set later in the day here at Benbrook, you'll have a beautiful, though maybe annoying, sunlit fairway here, kind of coming at your eyes though. Water is long of this because apparently some nutrients are damming it up, causing a little bit of a wetland to grow there. So you can't just blast this one out the back willy-nilly. You're gonna wanna play your Connor O'Reilly compass that ranges out perfectly for this 357-foot hole. You're probably gonna play it on just a touch drag over, give it about 12 feet of height at the apex so it has time to flatten. You're gonna shank it on that exact angle, a little bit right. Leave yourself with a throw-in opportunity. Cause I gotta show you guys how good the faith is for those 160 footers. Orange dreamsicle time. Gave it a bit of an effort. Pretty disappointed I didn't let this thing fly the way it's supposed to though, because this is the perfect hole to show it off. Hurts me to par, because I like hole 17 so much. It's a good one. We have identified this beautiful tree giving us the fall vibes as Chinese tallow actually, so I think it's invasive and don't encourage the spread of it. We got a hawk right there. Across the way on that little branch, you see it? It might even have a fish in its talons. You see him over there? Perched up. Might have just caught him a little sunfish. Snacking down, trying to keep its balance. You guys know we love birds of prey here on the Connor O'Reilly YouTube channel. Maybe my favorite part of the course right here. The Red Sea of trees has parted. Because I am disc golf Jesus. That's right, you heard it. Finishing off out here at Benbrook with a par four, a little bit under 600 feet. There's an out of bounds creek in the middle up there, maybe about 325 feet or so off the tee. Couple options here. Lowest ceiling is gonna be on the left side, but once you're through it, not a lot in your way to get you to a landing zone that can give you a lane into the basket. Also, this right side has a little bit more ceiling, though you do have a tree kind of splitting the middle down there. Then you got to beat either side and try to get your disc back left, but not too far left. I always try to squeak one through the tree limbs over the top here, and I ended up in the creek earlier, also through a roller that was in the creek. And with my limited bag set up, I don't know, I kind of not really sure what I want to throw here. This one just feels so handcuffing. I usually kind of out of boredom throw something over the top on this hole instead of just playing a layup shot. I'm gonna try to rip this cloud breaker, beat that second tree on the inside, and see if I can skip over the creek. Ambition is priceless. Ain't that what Wally said, right? Give me the skip now. Give me the big skip. Nope. Just dead straight into the OB long. Ah, that one had such good speed. I just needed to get some left edge to get it to lift up in the air and skip. I'll show you guys the putter play off the tee. Show you guys the basic one. Just play faith out to the left. Nice and controlled, and then you can either hyzer or forehand in from there. I'll play that one out just to show you guys that shot as well, and we'll see which one scores better. From this putter off the tee shot, we're left with maybe 300 feet in. I can either go big wide Annie with the compass or up the gut, a little bit of turn. What are you thinking, Caddy? She wants up the middle, I already know. No point in even asking, so. You know, I'll throw it. Flex the gap hitting skills. Just set the angle of turn on this compass. Hit the gap, held some turn. I got a long look. And that's how the course designer designed this hole. I picked up the DD3, no need to play out that out of bounds shot for you guys, you know. We still have a birdie look here. Circle two redemption to end the day would be quite the glorious way to go out. He did it! He made a circle two putt with the faith. Made the adjustment. Wow. Feels good to finally make the first circle two putt of Vlogmas. It feels like I might have made one somewhere else, but that definitely felt like it. Definitely the first jumper we made. Benbrook is an awesome course up here in North Austin. Big thanks again to the Hill Country Hyzers and everyone who's worked on the course over the last year and a half to make it one of the best courses in Austin. While it is on the shorter side, it has good technicality, a good mix of shot shapes, and it tests even the better players to keep their focus sharp and to hit their lines. Tomorrow is day 5, which means giveaway number 2, so you're going to want to check that out, and you're going to want to jump on that within 24 hours of that Instagram post coming up to enter to win those discs and whatever else we give away. Who knows? Thanks for joining. Don't forget to hit that subscribe, share it with a friend or two, because that's really what matters. And more importantly, just share disc golf with them, because we all love this beautiful game.